Well, as technology continues to grow, cyberbullying, we've talked about a lot here on 4, but it is a real problem ongoing for many teenagers and younger people as well. Your family can get some help combating cyberbullying through some upcoming workshops that are free for you. We'll get to those in just a minute. First, joining us, Beth Confer with Clarity Child Guidance Center. Thank you very much for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
How big a problem is it? As a dad of a teenager and a tween, I hear about it a lot. I ask, I keep asking, and I haven't had anything with me.
Well, you're doing the right thing by asking. So we know that over 50% of kids are being bullied. And I think that's a little bit low, actually.
Really?
Mm-hmm. And we know that of those kids who are bullied, only 1 in 10 reports it. And then 1 in 5 reports it to the police.
Well, and the cyberbullying especially, I guess those of us who never had to deal with this as kids, we don't understand how brutal that can be.
Yes, and it is brutal and it's relentless because children are always attached to their devices. It can be absolutely overwhelming for children who are experiencing bullying because they can get bullied through their phones, through their laptops, through their gaming systems.
And they're not going to tell you about it, as you said. So what are the signs that a parent should look out for?
So you have to be part detective and know your child well. If they're acting out of character, then I would certainly ask about that. Younger kids may not be able to verbalize this is happening to me. They may complain of stomach aches or headaches, things like that, physical symptoms.
Not want to go to school, but they're not sick.
School refusal is a big one.
Mm-hmm. And then what can you do?
If your child is being bullied?
Right. If you think they are and you finally get it out of them, yeah, well, they're doing this to me at school.
Well, I would say as a parent, always monitor and limit screen time. And then if you find out that your child is being bullied, save all those messages, whether it's voicemail, email, text, save all of them so that those can be used in the report.
And now we hear about David's law, this bill going through the legislature. Right now, people might think, well, what is there really that I can do except tell my kid, you know, buck up? That's kind of the old school. Mm-hmm. What do you tell parents about that who have that attitude?
Who have the attitude that
they should just toughen themselves up?
Well, I can tell you as a counselor, it is devastating to children if they have rumors that have been started about them or if they're being bullied in any way, but cyberbullying is especially devastating. So as a parent, I would want to get the school involved if this is taking place at school.
And now we also had some information, you saw a little bit about the workshops that you guys are involved in through BiblioTech.
Mm-hmm. So yes, those workshops are taking place tomorrow and Thursday night from 6 to 8. The information is on your screen, so tomorrow is at Last Chance Ministries.
And you can ask all kinds of questions. It's really more complicated than we think because kids are into different apps these days and they move from one app to another. What are the big apps you should watch out for?
Well, they change constantly, but Instagram is a big one. Of course, everybody knows Facebook. There are actually mechanisms on those service providers that you can use to report that bullying behavior.
All right. Well, great information. And again, we will have on our website how you can get more information on those workshops. Thank you very much. Beth Confer, Clarity Child Guidance Center.
Delaine? Nice.
All right.